Welcome back once again, everyone. Prestige here, bringing up to number 5 of the Road to Diamond, and this time I'll be covering the DSR-50 bolt-action sniper rifle, customized with ballistic CPU, laser sight, and fast mag attachments, playing some team deathmatch on Hydro. I hope you all enjoy the gameplay and commentary. Without further ado, let's begin. If I were to give you a major piece of advice about sniping, that would be play how you want to. No matter if you're hard scoping, quick scoping, you're always going to be criticized by the other team for doing it, whether you're sitting in the back of the spawn or just being an aggressive player running into their spawn and taking them out left and right like I'm doing in this gameplay. It all depends on how you play. Also, keep in mind that the scope is on the gun for a reason. Use it. Get those one-shot kills. No matter what kind of criticism you get, just remember you are indefinitely the better player for getting the kill on the enemy that's pretty much just trying to show off and get those cool kills. If you're getting those one-shot kills, you're going to be getting your camouflages leading you up to the diamond weapon. Let's talk about the perk setup. The setup in this gameplay is definitely geared toward the aggressive player. Coming in at tier 1, I got Lightweight Ghost. Tier number 2, I got Toughness. And tier 3, I like to rock Tactical Mask. Lightweight actually increases your mobility to an assault rifle pace, and it'll also help you dodge bouncing Bettys and Claymores. But just remember, diving to prone causes more harm than it does good, and you'll inevitably die because you won't hit the ground before the bouncing Betty explodes. Plus, it's sort of like a useless feature. It should have never been added. And if you've ever played Search and Destroy and tried to defuse a bomb, well, you know how much harm it causes there. Ghost is self-explanatory. It helps you stay off the radar at all times from your enemy, especially while keeping that mobility. And Toughness is an amazing perk. If you're aiming at your enemy and you are just pretty much, I guess you would say, hard scoping, you won't have to readjust if your enemy's shooting back at you. Plus, it helps in tight situations where you're getting shot first. You can quote-unquote quickscope your enemy, and just the feeling of getting the kill is pretty awesome. Tactical Mask, just to kind of negate the effects of shock charges, flashbangs, and stun grenades. Those things will be so ineffective you won't even have to worry about it. But let's talk about game types. One thing I cannot stress enough is make sure you're playing a game mode that won't only help you, but also help your team. There's two main types of snipers in Call of Duty Black Ops 2. One is aggressive, and the other is defensive. Defensive snipers typically like to patrol one area, block doorways with bouncing Bettys and shock charges, and snipe anyone that comes within their path. And, you know, they rarely will move on. They'll probably come back to the same area, and you could just kill them from wherever you are. Aggressive snipers like myself like to run around, pick off enemies, get killed, run back into the battle, pick off some more enemies, get killed, and run back in. If you're planning on playing Demolition, Domination, Search and Destroy, or any other game type, make sure you have an aggressive playstyle. You want to plan objectives. You want to capture objectives. You want to take out enemies and support your team. If you're a defensive sniper, I can definitely recommend playing like Team Deathmatch, Free For All. If you're playing Team Deathmatch for your team and you're rocking the UAV, Hunter Killer, Counter UAV combo, the UAV and the Counter UAV will help you find enemies and help you hide your own teammates that don't have silencers or suppressors. Hunter Killer will actually be thrown in the air and will search for your enemies, take them out, and put up some more points for your team. And that's just a really easy way, an awesome way to look at it. If you aren't a defensive sniper, if you're an aggressive sniper, Kill Confirmed is a awesome game type to play for a lot of kills, a lot of bloodthirsties, and a lot of kill streaks. And that's just my recommendation on what game modes you play. But let's get into the real talk. Attachments will either make you or break you, depending on what game type you're playing and how you're playing it. For example, if you're playing Domination and you're protecting the B flag, throw up a smoke grenade and use your dual band scope to take out enemies that try to take it back. It's just a ridiculously easy way to get bloodthirsty kills and one-shot kills. Also, if you're playing aggressively like I am here, there's always top 3 attachments that I can recommend because, well, about 3 to 4 months before this game came out, I actually got invited to Treyarch to play the multiplayer aspect of it. And I will always remember it because I made Hutch rage so bad. And if you guys want to see the official video, it's down below in the description. That video got stolen by a lot of people, and you can actually watch the official one down below. A lot of people did get permission from me, though, before uploading it, but still, regardless of who uploaded it, it was still me playing with the DSR-50. Very first sniper I ever used in the game, and I always recommend the ballistic CPU to help with weapon sway, the laser sight to help with hipfire accuracy, and the fast mag attachment to help you reload faster. It's just an awesome set of attachments to help your aggressive playstyle. The Ballistic CPU is really an awesome attachment. I think it could do a lot more than it does, but still, it's awesome, helps with weapon sway, and helps you get those one-shot kills. But guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have a gun that you want to see for the Road to Diamond, let me know down below in the description. I need to start uploading more Road to Diamonds. This is a more informational kind of video. And don't forget that I have that exclusive video down below in the description if you guys still want to watch it. Who knows, maybe you did see it on someone else's channel, I don't know. But just know that it was me playing with the DSR-50, and the person screaming in the video was indeed Hutch getting so mad. But guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please drop a like. If not, that's cool. And keep in mind, I am on the road to 50,000 subscribers. If you'd like to hit that subscribe button, please feel free to do so. And until next time, I am out. Peace.